was not planning on doing this. Usually I do, what I do is I film 2 RWBY reactions a day sometimes. No. After chapter 8 ended, I need to know what happens next. Like, literally, you can't just, how do you guys do it? How do you guys watch this weekly and have to deal with this cliffhanger? Like, these kinds of cliffhangers. Because most RWBY episodes end on cliffhangers. How do you do it? Oh god, I'm gonna be a mess in Volume 6 having to... If there's gonna be a bunch of cliffhangers in Volume 6, I'm not gonna make it for a week. I'll be dead within, like, the first hour. Raven. Oh shit, we're back here.
Raven.
Got some company.
What is it? Salem's found us. Salem. Okay.
How nonchalant she's like, Salem. Okay.
Bring me my helmet. Recognize the power of a maiden when they see it. Which is why we'd like to have a word with you. Leave us. Pack your things, then break down camp. We're moving.
This is gonna be a bloodbath, isn't it?
A little late to run and hide. You've been on our master's list for some time, so you must understand that we cannot allow you to slip away.
I know all about your master, but I don't believe we've met.
We're the guys you should be afraid of.
I doubt anyone should be afraid of you.
Oh, yeah? Tell that to Quiet.
That's what I thought. I'm Cinder. This is my associate, Arthur Watts. And my disciples, Emerald and Mercury. 2 children you've tricked into following you. A disgraced Elysian scientist. And a fall maiden with a surname so appropriate she probably picked it herself. Something tells me you've got more than a slight case of egomania. Is that about right?
Technically, I was also a doctor, but I must say the rest was spot on.
Okay.
Aren't you perceptive? That's what's kept me alive. I'm afraid the only reason you're still alive is because you have something our master wants. Of course, if I'm wrong. Vernal! So, this is the long-lost Spring Maiden.
What?! Oh, Raven. I wonder if this little trick will work. Cause she ain't the Spring Maiden, Raven is. They already confirmed it in, like, chapter 1. Oh god.
Vernal has done well under my guidance. I'd take that into consideration before you try anything.
I think we're gonna have a fight here.
Raven, I won't underestimate you, so please don't insult my intelligence. There is a slim chance you and your maiden could escape here today. But if you know our master as well as you claim to, then you know you could never truly escape. But we come bearing an olive branch.
The maidens are merely a means to an end. Salem's true desires are the relics locked within the Huntsman Academy. Come with us. Allow Vernal here to unlock the relics. Salem, you'll be forgiven. It's the best deal.
Raven's not going to. She's not going to do this shit.
You talk as if walking straight into Haven will be easy. That's because it will be. Headmaster Lionheart is loyal to Salem now. All we need is the key to the vault. You're not the only one to turn your back on Oz, Raven. I'm not helping Salem. I'm not helping Oz.
We're gonna have a fight.
I don't want a part in any of this.
I think.
That ship sailed when you chose to harbor a maiden. But if you come with us to Haven, we'll leave you, your tribe, and your little secret to live out the rest of your days wobbling in the wilderness. We just need the relic.
She's not gonna do it.
I need time to think this over.
You don't have time. In 2 days, Haven Academy will be destroyed by the White Fang. You're going to choose now.
Don't do it, Raven.
Corner, huh? So, are you with us?
She's so not with them.
Or against us? Agreements like these are built on trust. And forgive me for saying, but I don't trust a single one of you.
That's right.
You need to give me more.
You are in a poor position to negotiate.
I want my brother dead. Crow? That's right. He knows I have spring. And if I help you get your relic, he's going to become a problem. I have enough problems to deal with. Crow doesn't trust me.
She is so playing them.
If Leo really is loyal to you, then you can order him to invite Crow right into an ambush. He arrives at Haven, we take him down, you get your relic, and we all leave happy. Now this is a proposition I can get behind.
All right, ladies, let's pause for a moment. We have one objective. Retrieving the relic of knowledge. Now, Crow Bronwyn may be on our list of individuals we would very much like dead, but he's not going to go down without a fight, and he's not going to fight quietly. Our advantage here is just as you said. We walk straight into Haven. No resistance, no one the wiser. The battle with your brother throws that all out the window.
He's good, but not that good. All of us against him, it'll be over in a heartbeat.
She is so playing
but
them.
It's not just him. He has the students with him. He has RWBY. He certainly does.
If we leave that school
alone, Cinder,
it will draw the attention of the authorities. The kingdom will be on high alert, and the White Fang's attack will be ruined.
Then we wait. We wait until the full moon. Leo invites Crow and his little fighters to Haven the same night Hazel and Adam arrive with the White Fang. As soon as the battle is won, the White Fang demolishes Haven. And any evidence we may have left behind is lost along with the school. Then Salem leaves my people alone. For good. You have yourself a deal.
They're playing each other.
Wait. Don't think I don't see what you're after. If this falls to pieces over your grudge with a child, I will not be taking the blame.
Then what are you worried about?
Raven's obviously playing them, and Cinder, well, is Cinder.
And tell Salem she'll get what she wants. And more.
Raven's gonna betray them all. Oh shit, are we back with the Belladonnas? Yep. Come on. Fuck you and your spear. Oh, please kill these fucking bitches. Oh. Please tell me he got impaled and it wasn't like part of his clothing. Oh, fuck. Oh no. I love you, son. Was part of his fucking clothing. Shit. It's kind of cool, though. Blake. Come on, Blake. God, that was fucking cool.
Dad, where's Mom?
I'm not sure. I got ambushed right away.
Once we take down Korsak and Finnick.
No, go now.
But...
You keep assuring me your friend isn't a complete waste of space. Let's see him prove it.
We got this, Blake. I've wanted to sock these creeps since the day we met.
Hurry.
Hurry. You have to get in line. Blake, go.
You got this, Blake. Oh my god.
Yes, Renal.
I followed them as you asked. Did they spot you?
Of course not.
They have a ship 2 clicks west of here. Looks like they're staying there for the night.
Thank you, Renal. Anything else?
Do you actually believe they'll let us go once they have the relic?
No.
Of course not. They'll never leave us alone. Once our purpose has come and gone, we'll be discarded. Salem only uses people until they are no longer useful. If we want to have any chance of defending ourselves against her, then we need this relic. If Crow and those brats want to follow Osmond, then let them.
Hey.
When the chaos reaches its peak, we'll grab them and make our escape.
And the fact that your daughter won't be part of all that
doesn't matter. I warned her.
Fuck you.
This path won't be easy for us either, but we must do what's right for the tribe.
I know. I'll do whatever it takes.
Good.
Oz needs to talk to you.
Come on, Blake, go find your mother. Ilya. Don't do this, Ilya. She doesn't want to do it. She can't. But they're gonna fight anyway. She's gonna do it. God, why do they keep doing that? Why do they hate me? Are you kidding me? Are you actually shitting me right now? I started chapter 9 to see what would happen with Blake's family, like the outcome. I didn't get that. They ended on another freaking cliffhanger. Man, I would have been even more pissed if I was watching this live and I had to wait another week. I'd be pissed. Literally, oh... Right from the get-go, I knew Cinder and Raven were playing each other. Which is obvious. And, yeah, because Vernal is not the Spring Maiden. Raven is. Because A, it was obvious already. And B, they confirmed it in, like, chapter 1. Or 2. But no, I think it was chapter 1. Oh, God. Blake and Ilya are gonna have a fight. Oh, God, I really hope her father doesn't die. Or her mother. For all I know, her mother could already be dead because she was going to find her. Oh, this is the time where Ilya needs to redeem herself. She didn't do it before, but she'll do it now. She has to do it now! Come on, Ilya. That was RWBY, Volume 5, Chapter 9. fucking cliffhangers. So, I guess I'll be doing chapter 10 next, and if that ends in a cliffhanger, well, then I'll have to deal with it, because this is my third one already, so... Oh, God. Please don't end on a cliffhanger. Please don't end on a cliffhanger. For all I know, it will. Well, thank you all so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Be sure to subscribe for more RWBY reactions, and I will see you guys next time.